Greetings, dear friends, and welcome to the Blue Cube YouTube channel. In continuation of Adobe Animate software training, in this video, you will learn how to work with Paint Bucket, Ink Bottle, and Asset Warp tools. To see more tutorials, subscribe to my channel. Getting started with the Paint Bucket tool. We'll begin by using the Paint Bucket tool. To utilize this tool, which is located in this section, we'll create a line using the Brush tool. The lines must cross each other to form a closed shape, or we can create other shapes in this manner. For instance, if we want to color the interior of this shape, we cannot typically select the shape and fill it with color. For example, if I change the fill here, you'll notice that the color of the line I drew with the brush changes. However, if we want to color the interior of this shape, we can only do so with the Paint Bucket tool. I'll select this tool and go to the tool panel. Now let's choose a color for the shape's interior, such as red, and click here. As you can see, the shape's interior is now red. We can also choose a different color, such as yellow or blue, and click here. This will fill the interior sections of the shape with that color. Press Ctrl plus A and then delete to remove the shapes. You can achieve the same result using the pen tool. For instance, use the pen tool to create a closed shape. If you want to fill it with color, you can choose a color again and click here with the Paint Bucket tool to fill the interior. I'll select the shape using the Free Transform tool. Now, we can change the stroke color and increase its value, as well as change the fill color again. If I right-click on the Paint Bucket tool, the Ink Bottle tool is also available. Its purpose is to create strokes. To achieve this, I'll first select the interior color using the Selection tool and place it here. As you can see, this color is now only the fill color. We can change its color from here. Now, to create a stroke for the interior color, I'll select the Ink Bottle tool here and click on this edge here. The stroke is created in this simple manner. I'll select the shape again using the Free Transform tool and double-click to select the entire shape. I'll reposition it, and you can change the stroke and fill colors from here. So, the Paint Bucket tool fills the interior of closed paths, and the Ink Bottle tool creates strokes. We can also easily select a portion of the stroke here and adjust its value. Well, those were the two tools I wanted to introduce to you. I'll delete the shapes. Now, friends, there is another tool called Asset Warp. I'll select the Asset Warp tool. The shortcut for this tool is the letter V. To use this tool, I'll create a rectangle. I'll select it using the Free Transform tool and assign it a color. For instance, I'll choose a gray or blue color. To make it clearer, I need to reduce the stroke. Alternatively, I can temporarily remove the stroke from here. Now, I'll zoom in on the shape using the Zoom tool. Hold down the left mouse button and drag to get a better view of the shape. Now, I'll select the Asset Warp tool. This tool allows us to create wavy patterns on the shape. Note that when you select Asset Warp, the tool settings are displayed in the tool panel. Now, when I click on the shape, its color changes slightly, indicating that the shape is ready for modification. And the shape settings are once again activated in the object panel, allowing us to change its color. If I click again, a mesh with a point is created on the shape. When the point is created, dragging the mouse will reveal a bone connected to the point. This bone is used to connect the points together and establishes relationships between them. However, if I don't want these points to be connected, I'll click the red point once more. It will be deselect, and the bone will be hidden. I'll click again in the center of the shape, and you'll see that the point turns red again and another bone is created. If I click the red point again, that bone will disappear, and I'll create one more point at the end. I'll click on the point to deselect it. Now, we can hold down the left mouse button on the points with the same Asset Warp tool and drag them down. This allows us to create a curved shape for our own shape. We can create as many points as we want on our shape. I'll press Ctrl plus Z. I'll create another point in this section. I'll click on it again and I'll do the same here. Now, I can easily create the warp effect for my shape again. You can do this without any limitations. And since we didn't select the bone mode, each point creates its own curvature and bending effect. The settings for the Asset Warp tool are available in both the Tool panel and the Object panel, and we can use them. For example, we can reduce the mesh value from here. The lower the value, the better, because if you increase it too much, it may put pressure on your system and you won't be able to continue working. If we click on the eye icon, we won't be able to see the mesh anymore. It still functions, but it's no longer visible. There is another option here called envelope. If we activate it, you can see that hollow circles have been created in the corners, which we can move around in this way. And we can use the levers it gives us to change the shape of our own. I'll disable it again. I'll smooth out the shape a bit to bring it back to its previous state. I'll activate envelope again. Using these points and levers, we can transform the shapes into whatever we want. We will animate all of these things that my friend is telling you, and we will transform one shape into another. Now, friends, I'll select and delete the shape. I'll create another shape and select the Asset Warp tool again. This time, I won't double-click and I want the bone to be created. And I'll create another bone here. Finally, I'll click on it to deselect the bone and allow us to continue working easily. Now, if I hold down the left mouse button on this point, you can see that I can move the point independently. And if I move the other points, you can see that this point follows the previous point and moves. Notice, I make it smaller, I make it bigger, this point moves too, and it's no longer separate. Because we activated the bone mode, that point moves with it. But if I move this point, the previous point doesn't move. Now, we will discuss bones in detail in the next lesson. If I move the starting point, the whole shape moves like this. So, the starting point moves the whole thing. And if I change this, it moves the top point. If I change the last point, it moves alone, and it creates a slight change in the other parts. Now, when we want to create bones, we can choose the hard or soft mode for them. The flexi mode gives us levers that we can also use. The shape changes depending on which option you choose. We can also use the bone rotation option to rotate the points. We can change and rotate the selected point from here. If my friends select a point and activate the freeze point option. Now, if I make changes here, you can see that this point stays in place and no longer follows the previous point. Because we froze that point. If I select it again and disable freeze point, the point moves easily. So, we can use this option in this way. Now, since my friends haven't taught me about the timeline and animation yet, I don't want to go into that too much, because we can easily create different animations using this tool. But to show you how we use it, I'll quickly create an animation with the Asset Warp tool so that you can better understand this tool. We will teach you the timeline and animation in full detail in the next lesson. I'll click on frame 50 and then press the F6 key. This will select my shape using the F6 key. I'll make a change to the shape. Click or double-click on this gray area to turn it blue. I'll right-click on it and select the Create Classic Tween option here. This way, friends, you can see that I have an animation here. Okay, friends, I don't want to go too far with this now. In the next lessons, when I teach you about the timeline and animation, you will get familiar with all of these things and you will be able to create different animations. Thank you for staying with me until the end of this video. Remember, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, click the subscribe button or the subscribe below the video, and please like the video. Goodbye for now.